There are other cars there that have wanted to have this endurance race more than ever before. Rafael from Lazy Gecko with a victory yesterday, wants to get their first endurance win ever. And also, the Van Gogh, the vehicle that has been the quickest and tightest in so many possible ways. Will that strategy work out? Will putting themselves in absolute peril pay off, be able to squeeze through traffic in a 75-minute battle royale that absolutely requires you to fit in tighter spots with less time and hopefully fighting down your teeth and getting through it in one piece? But they'll have to get through the F-150, which is brutally quick, but has yet to prove itself in endurance glory. Whereas Ari Greasy has also proven itself in endurance glory, but has not proven itself to be as quick. But its survival ratio could put it back on the podium or better. And it still has to beat, though, MIT's own with the electric Kool-Aid acid bus racing, a dominant vehicle in New York, but so far not so lucky this year at the start of their season. Patrick, it is going to be an absolute stunning race, and we're going to see who is possibly the best. Track marshals, are you ready? Can I get a thumbs up for the track marshals? Anyway, round of applause for our track marshals. They put themselves in danger for your entertainment. Drivers, are you ready to race? And most importantly, fans, are you ready to race? All right, well, let us begin the warm-up lap. All right, so this is the last time actually we've been for warm-up. Absolutely, everyone, wave these cars goodbye. The warm-up lap begins now. Make sure all these transponders are ready to be cars. The last time you're going to see in this condition, 75 grueling minutes. These cars are going to fight. And a wonderful benefit for them right now, as the sun is briefly cooling these cars off. The Group B did not have as much luck. They were in absolute new sunshine, and the cars heated up as a consequence. In the back of the field, that gray and red Mercedes, known as Mercedes S-Class Warfare, has had very questionable reliability, but is possibly the fastest car on grid, and it's all the way in the back. We're going to see how it does today in the endurance race. Yesterday, it tore apart its car twice in both sprints. First the motor shaft, and then one of the tire rods. So Patrick, the grid is lining up. Ready when you are. All right, I need everyone's help counting down. Drivers, prepare to race.